I'm getting ready to leave, it'll probably get a little emotional. And I've told myself when I do leave that I'm not going to do that. We'll see what happens, I suppose.
Coming up, the Council Biography Series. Meet Prescott City Council members in one-on-one candid interviews. And now your host, Kim Capen, with Councilman Bob Roecker.
Two-term City Councilman Bob Roecker has a public service resume that stretches over two decades. But earlier this year, the man known around City Hall as the Voice of Reason announced that he will not seek a third council term. With Roecker's experience and popularity, the question is, what makes Bob not want to run? But before discussing Mr. Roecker's present, let's take a look at his past.
Bob Roecker was born in Wisconsin, but his family began looking for a warmer climate to ease his father's worsening arthritis, eventually settling in Tucson when young Bob was just 3 years old. Roecker recalls being a spirited but otherwise typical Arizona kid and not always the voice of reason.
If you ask people, they would say I was a little Dickens. Now, of course, I don't see it that way, but I did get my measure of swats in school. Back then we still had corporal punishment, and I got a few, a little straighten you out a little bit. You're kind of going off in the wrong path here a little bit.
Roecker, who remains fit as ever at age 61, discovered his first love in junior high school, baseball. He credits the game with playing a major role in his early development, drive to succeed, and eventually for providing a sorely needed reality check.
When I was in seventh grade, I tried out for the baseball team, the junior high baseball team, and I got cut. And I can remember standing and looking at that thing on the wall saying who made the team and who didn't. And my name wasn't up there. And I made a vow that I would never allow that to happen to me again. And what a motivator to get cut from a team and then come, and say that's the last time that's going to happen to me. And then I made the team the next year, and I got to play, speaking of being a jock, got to play high school baseball all the way through my senior year and started and loved every minute of it. And I can remember getting up to bat against an individual who eventually made it to the pros. And he threw me 9 pitches, two fastballs and a curve, 3 times in a row, and I swung at all 9 pitches and never even fouled the ball off. That's when the light went on that I was not going to ever go on in sports.
Though Roecker may have struck out on the baseball diamond, he did succeed at striking up a romance with a girl named Wendy, who would later become his wife.
Believe it or not, we were high school sweethearts, and after we both started going to the University of Arizona, we decided to get married, so we got married, and I've been married ever since. We have 2 wonderful children and 5 grandchildren, and it's been great. I'm not going to try to say how long we've been married because it's too risky.
Roecker went on to study secondary education at the University of Arizona, paying his way through college, working long hours as a short-order cook, and later for a property title insurance company. After receiving his degree in 1970, Roecker did a stint in the Arizona National Guard and opted for a career in the title business rather than education. In the meantime, his family grew, and an itch for change sent the Roecker clan from Tucson to Havasu City to Colorado Springs, and finally, in 1980, to Prescott.
Unlike many longtime residents, Roecker says Prescott is a better place to live today than it was 3 decades ago.
When you'd go out somewhere in the evening, you'd know everybody that was in the restaurant or where you were. And that was fun, that was good. But we have more opportunities now, we have more things to do now here than we've ever had, and I don't see that as a negative at all.
In the early 90s, Roecker took a job with Printpack, a Prescott Valley manufacturing firm. He's been their environmental and safety coordinator for nearly 19 years and expects to retire from the company soon.
It's important stuff because, a company like Printpack, who is now international, we want to do the right thing all the time. Mm-hmm. So evidence of that is a guy like me mm-hmm. in the plant whose job it is to make sure that we are keeping track of and complying with all the rules mm-hmm. and regulations.
Roecker's determination to do the right thing led him into a public service career. He served as president of the Prescott Chamber of Commerce and participated on various economic development committees. In 2001, Roecker won a seat on the Prescott City Council. Since then, one of his primary goals has been to build a better water future for the city through the Big Chino Water Project.
I like to look at myself as a champion of that particular issue, because ultimately water is the most important thing we're talking about. Without it, we can't do anything further into the future. We will stymie ourselves. And not that we have to continuously grow, but the folks have to remember that since 1998, we've been mining water out of the Little Chino Aquifer. And we can't continue to do that without coming up with an alternative source. And the legislature back in the 90s, I believe it was, allowed us to go to the Big Chino to acquire water, mm-hmm. which is what we're doing, in the process of doing now.
He remains confident that scientific studies, as well as city and town oversight, will, in the end, have a positive result without a negative impact on the Verde River.
I've lived here a long time, too, mm-hmm. and I don't want anything to happen to the Verde River. Just because I live on this side doesn't mean I don't care about what's happening mm-hmm. to that river. Mm-hmm.
Economic development with regional benefit was another area championed by Roecker. His association with PrintPak shaped his understanding of manufacturing's powerful impact on a community.
Industries that come into a community create an economic base that is, in my opinion, stronger than big boxes and tourism and all the rest of it, because the dollar stays in the community and turns over more often, and I think economic people would tell you that.
When Roecker looks back at his 8 years on city council, he's satisfied that he's played a role in making decisions that have improved Prescottonians' quality of life.
Around City Hall, those close to Roecker offer these personal reflections.
He's always kind of the voice of reason. He's extremely level-headed, he's very pro-business, but he's also, you know, government doesn't always need to be involved in everything.
But I think Bob was on this council before I came, certainly was a help while I was there. We don't necessarily always vote the same, but I think Bob Roecker is such a plus to this community.
He dropped the ball in the championship of the free world and cost us the game. It was the bottom of the seventh inning. We were up by 3 runs. They had got the bases loaded, but we had 2 outs, and it was a simple pop fly. And I have never let him forget it, that in his backing up, hollering, I got it, I got it, I got it, about the third time, he tripped on the sprinkler, fell on his butt, the ball hit behind him, and 4 runs scored, and we all went down to Canarios and had a beer.
Asked why he chose not to run for re-election, Roecker simply said, it's just time to go. However, he did talk about the challenges of being in public office, good and bad press, and his fellow council members.
It pulls a little on family life on occasion, and it's one of the things, if you're going to run for office, that you have to expect will happen to you. But I think early on, in an editorial, I was called wise. And I thought at the time, that's nonsense. I think of the praise as pretty much one end of the spectrum and the criticism at the other end of the spectrum. So it's kind of like, it ends up kind of like being water off a duck's back. People I've been working with on the councils over the years have all been outstanding. You'd have to thank your family, of course, and you have to thank your employer who's given me the opportunity to leave work and come do this, you know, and they've made arrangements for me to do that, which has been, you know, incredibly helpful. Without that, I couldn't have done it. When I'm getting ready to leave, it'll probably get a little emotional. And I've told myself when I do leave that I'm not going to do that. We'll see what happens, I suppose.
When Bob Roecker walks out of council chambers for the final time, there's little doubt that he'll be missed by his peers, city staff, and the community. I'm Kim Capen. Join us next time for Prescott's City Council Biography Series.